to do something to get their attention. He had allowed them, after bringing them out of 400 years of slavery, only for them not to understand who the one true God was. He allowed the Babylonians to overtake them. God, I don't know about you. Hallelujah. But I was one that if you whoop me for one day, hallelujah, I might try it one more time. But after that, I was not trying to take a whooping for the same thing over and over again. But there's an unfortunate reality is that we are a people that does not learn from our mistakes. We always think that we can do it better than the last person. Our mentality takes us to a place where we think they wasn't smart enough to pull it off, that they did something wrong, that they dropped the ball. Hallelujah. But I have to make it plain. The wages of sin is death. Hallelujah. But I'm so glad that the word of God didn't stop there. Because it goes on to say that the gift of God is eternal life. Hallelujah. I'm so glad. Hallelujah. That God delayed his return just enough time to allow me to get myself together. I'm so glad that the Lord didn't come back while I was out drinking. I'm so glad that the Lord didn't come back when I was out smoking weed with my friends. I'm so glad. Hallelujah. That the Lord didn't come back while I was out fornicating. I'm so glad. God. Somebody said, well, none of that was me. Well, maybe I'll give you one that'll hit home. I'm so glad that God didn't come back when I just told a lie. Oh, God, that somebody has the audacity to think I'm not that bad. Hallelujah. But the Bible says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. I know some of you try to think that you was perfect coming out of your womb, your mother's womb. Hallelujah. But the Bible says you was born in sin and shaped in iniquity. In other words, you was groomed and fashioned. Hallelujah. That the sin already laid inside of you. There was a seed of sin that had already been planted in you when you were conceived. Hallelujah. So when you came out of your mother's womb, hallelujah, there was already a sin nature down on the inside. We don't have to teach our kids how to sin. Hallelujah. There's so many things we teach our children. We teach them how to walk. We teach them how to speak correctly. We teach them their alphabet. We teach them their arithmetic. We teach them all these things. But the one thing we never have to teach them is how to sin. God, it's going to get tight here. Hallelujah. But I understand today that the church has become lax when it comes to sin. Hallelujah. We want to put a band-aid on it and pat them on the back and say it's going to be all right. Hallelujah. But the devil is a lie. Hallelujah. You got to get it right. Hallelujah. You got to do the work of them who has sent you while it is day. Because the night comes when no man can work. Hallelujah. In other words, hallelujah, and I might preach this on Wednesday. Payday is on the way. Hallelujah. You can work whoever you're going to work for. But understand, payday is on the way. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I can remember when I was working and I was on an hourly job. And I tried to work as many hours as I could. And I got excited about Friday because I knew payday. over me. I got to get happy about that. And don't nobody else get happy. Because I've gone through some mean times. I've gone through some sad times. I've gone through the hurt and the pain. I've gone through some times where my friends have turned their backs on me. I've gone through some times when people began to lie and talk about me. I've gone through some time when the church folks said that he ain't good for nothing. I've gone through some time when people ask, why are you elevated? Hallelujah, he's not ready. I've gone through some time. Oh, but I'm so glad that God don't look at what man looks at. God don't look at where I came from. Hallelujah, but he looks at the finish line. He looks at, hallelujah, he don't look at the lump of clay that sat on the potter's wheel. Hallelujah, dirty, don't look like anything. Not beautiful to the eye. But he said, if you give me just a little bit of time, hallelujah, let me put my hands to it. Let me put my workmanship to it. I'm going to mold it and make it into something. I'm going to shape and form it for my glory. Hallelujah, somebody. All right, let me get back. Let me get back. But he says, secondly, and he writes, hallelujah, beloved, or dear friends, I need to remind you of something. Hallelujah, because I look at the sign of the times. I'm taking the temperature, the spiritual temperature of the church. And I